Hello everyone, welcome back to the Model Workshop. Today we're going to be building up Revell USA's 1970 Buick GSX. What a hot looking car. Obviously General Motors used the same platform for a lot of vehicles, and the Buicks had a little bit of flair because they had that luxury name with the performance of the GSX. This must be an old monogram issue because it is 1/24th scale. It is a skill level 4. It has 106 parts and comes out to about 8¼ inches long. Let's take a look at everything in the cool box we will be able to build with. It is a 2-in-1 kit, giving you some options. Molded in white styrene, very easy to paint. We have our nice interior tub with door panels. These are 70s General Motors muscle cars, so the interiors really aren't all super flashy and twin tones and all that stuff. They're pretty generic, as in generic motors. That was one of the derogatory terms used by other manufacturers. We got the nice dashboard there, very well detailed. And of course, in that 1/24th scale, it's just a hair bigger than the 1/25th scale cars of the day. Nice looking stock GSX hood, very sharp, even got the dimple for the dashboard. Got our hood scoops there, nice looking. We got some wheel backs, spring and shock options. It's not stock options, shock options. We've got our suspension and driveline package here. We've got links and sway bars. We've got front suspension, differential. We've got intakes and manifolds. Dual exhausts, all one piece, hanging off the back. Each section is a separate piece, but it's all one piece front to back. Drive shaft, belt and pulley, radiator line. There's our starter if you're looking for it when you're assembling the engine. On this section here, we've got the beautiful under chassis. Fuel tank, we got some of our linkages molded in, but that's very nice, deep detail on there. Got those hot looking sport bucket seats. Engine and transmission package, looks like firewall detail, radiator and radiator surround. Let's take a look at the top side of that, just so you can see the detail on there for you custom detailers. On this one, we've got our 2-in-1 hood, our optional high-rise intake hood. We've got our taller springs for the back end and our taller shocks. Steering wheel, fan, steering column, distributor. We've got our mirrors right there. Suspension arms and those wheel backs. Nice detail on the hood, top and bottom. We've got a nice one-piece spoiler. I do like them one-piece. For one, the detail is there. It's beautiful. Excellent shape. And I don't have to try to glue on the little nubs and get it to sit perfectly straight. I can just glue it onto the vehicle and it works the first time every time. And then that hot GSX body. Sharp-looking car. The big boat GMs. Nice looking. I like that the molding along the bottom is prominent so I can get that shined up. We got our wheel trims, and that is, you can feel the lip around it and you can see it. Nice window trim, trunk lids, and being the monogram molds, we got our tank, our battery, top of the radiator, reservoir tank all molded in. With the firewall, I'm pretty sure that extra detail we saw will glue into the back there. Nice looking kit. So let's get to the other side of the table. We will first pull out the stock tires and the custom tires. These are a taller tire for the back end of the car. They are no-name tires with a nice tread pattern on them. They are solid vinyl rubber. And then we've got the four stock tires off there. Tire tree, no names on those, same tread pattern. So you can do a completely stock GSX, you can do a little bit of a custom with those raised springs and the fatter tires on the back end. We've got some transparent parts, including the windshield, back glass, and headlights. Nicely molded, clear, minimal distortion on the curved piece, absolutely none on the flat back window. Transparent red taillights, always like that. Just speeds up the steps a little bit. A nice large chrome tree full of stock and custom parts. Check out those I had wheels like this on my GMC. Very cool. High-rise intake, carburation. We got two carburetors there. We got valve covers. Alternator with a bracket. Stock air cleaner. Stock wheels. I like those on there. Beautiful grill. Really sharp. And we get to put our headlights in there. We'll blackwash that grill in. We've got our rear bumper and tail section with our inserts for our clear red parts. That is our large chrome tree. And then we've got the decal sheet. Now, as you see, there are no decals to replicate the black striping. If you want to do that to your car, you can do so. If you customize it, then you don't have those decals. We've got these interesting pink, blue, and yellowish stripes. Very 70s, 80s custom look. We've got the stock black GSX stripes with that nice red trim all the way around. We've got dash gauges. We've got center caps. We've got nice New York Buick license plates. We got GSX name plates. We've got the name stickers for the engine. Look how those decals mold around the door handles. Sweet. Well done. Got seat belts in this one. We've got that center stripe. So if you paint the hood, you can just stripe the hood and then add your center stripe if you do it as a white GSX. So that's it. That's everything that's in the box. I'm going to get to building up my version and I'll be right back. Like they used to say to Mr. Connor, welcome back to the show. We've got sub-assembly time to look at everything. I didn't know this while I was looking at all the parts on the parts trees, and I'll show them to you. But you actually do get to do a little bit of assembly on the interior. You get to put these little door panels and door latches on. So that's cool. That's a nice little detail. The center console's already in there. We will get that painted up and detailed when we start getting paint on stuff. The exhaust and the drive shaft are lucky they're on similar trees. We can just hold those together and get them primed and painted as one unit and then gently slip them in. I think I may have to do a little bit of snipping on the exhaust to get it to fit in each side. I may have to cut the very bottom loop and then bring it in from both sides, but a touch of super glue and it's underneath the axle. You will never ever see that under there once I do it, and we can do that. We got the steering column glued together. We'll want to paint that up as one piece and detail it. We got the mirrors here. They'll be painted the body color, of course, and attached at a later point when I know I won't knock them off the body. The mirrors, always when there's no markers or anything, if you wanted to, you could insert a little wire into here by drilling it out and do all that stuff. I'll just glue them on gently with some thick super glue and do it that way. We got the dashboard ready to be painted up the interior color. We've got the wheel backs and the tack that's on the outside of the hood. That I want to paint a little separate than the hood just to draw more attention. It's going to be the same color, but I just want to paint it a little bit different so that you can actually see it bumped out a little bit more like you would on the real life one. We got our belt and pulley system and our little power steering reservoir right there. That's all set to go on. The alternator and its bracket will be attached at a later point, and our radiator hose. We got our firewall with our master cylinder and our brakes and all that. That will get painted up and then we'll glue that into place. That's a nice accessory there. Our radiator and shroud will be added. We got our two bucket seats glued together. They fit really nice. A lot of times seats won't go together very well, but after holding them with little clamps, that's a real nice job there. So the molding is nice and clean on those. We got our chassis together. We have the rear suspension in with our sway bar and our links. I've got the longer springs on it so that it sits a little high in the back end compared. And they would do that on the street cars too. When somebody would own it, they would do it and they would let it sit a little bit high in the back end as well. So that's what I figured whatever teenager bought this car used when they were dumping muscle cars towards the end of the 70s. Somebody bought this thing, some kid, and he lifted up the back end. It was one of the first modifications he made. We got our suspension arms on this side and our full suspension with lower suspension arms, steering and linkages and sway bar on the bottom. So that's ready to go. With that big hole in here means when you're doing your interior tub, make sure you get paint underneath here, whether you spray it or paint it. The body required only a little assembly, and that is attaching that spoiler all the way across the back. There should be a gap between the spoiler and the quarters there because of the fact that it's joined to the trunk lid here. And in real life, when that trunk lid lifts, if this was attached as one piece, your trunk would never open. And then you couldn't store your friends when you were going to the drive-in movie. But that glues on there so nicely. Love that spoiler on there, all one piece. Then I know I had it aligned correctly and it looks awesome. We've got our hood ready to paint. Got the nice detail under there, even some slits. You could probably even cut that out and then put some screens in there if you wanted to do a super custom build and make it look really awesome and open that up. And then we've got our big power plant under here. According to the instructions in the pictures, the distributor goes in the front of this one. Got our manifolds on there, valve covers, intake. I'm going to be doing mine a little custom, as if he swapped out the intake and stuff like that. So I'll be painting mine up, decorating it that way. I left the valve covers off. I left the transmission pan off so I can put those on because those are on the chrome tree and we can accent that later. On the back of the nose piece is the hood latch assembly. I did glue that in now. I will paint that with hand paint, but I wanted to make sure the super glue could bind in there nice and strong, and it does fit in those holes well, so that was not a problem. And then I will decide, do I want to use these wheels? Do I want to mix match them? Do I want to put customs in the back and stocks in the front? What do I want to do with it? It's my car. So I'm going to be building it up my way. We're going to get everything into paint. You'll be able to see the colors I picked right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's take a look-see at what I've gotten done and what needs to get done to finish up the model. Well, pretty much all that's left at this point is final assembly and decals. I've cut these off here because these are the ones I'm going to be using on this model. We've got our hockey stripes here. These ones go all the way to the front of the car, and as you can see, they fold around the door handles right there. So, you know, just like the box art has it coming down, and then it goes up and over the spoiler and down and back around the other side. And then this GSX emblem, this black one, will go at the bottom of the spoiler. I guess it's somehow supposed to wrap around there according to the decal sheet. So that will be interesting to get that on there. We've got the rear bumper done with tail lights. We got the center painted black. Then I took a toothpick and scratched out the Buick script on there so we can see it. And I Mod Podged the lights in, as you saw in that part of the video. The nose requires a good amount of work. I black washed the grill, colored in the turn signals, installed the headlights, hand painted with yellow gloss acrylic testers the entire nose so that it will go in like so. We'll get it all fit in there nicely when we're all done, but then it will match up to the way it's supposed to be. So that looks good. We've got the hood done and decaled right away with that nice stripe. Got our tachometer glued into place, and as you can see, the tone is just different enough to make it stand out. It's a sharp looking hood. We got the trim in the hood. The hood installs onto the car just fine. We've got our chrome trim done. We've got our wheel trim and windows in. Got that spoiler, got our locks in, and then I took a fine line marker and did my panel lines on the yellow so that they actually show up so we can actually see the door panels on the car, and that yellow is turning out nice. I've got the mirrors with their lenses glued in place. Those will be installed last, and that will be the most frustrating part of the build. It won't be the decals. You'd think it would, but it won't. We got one decal on here for the GS455. That will go on the air cleaner right in that nice little half moon. The chassis is all done. Just did basic work on the chassis. Got the radiator, coolant line, engine installed. You see, I went with an aftermarket look to the intake and stuff like that, just to look like he's dressed it up a little bit, modified it a little bit. Got the custom valve covers on there, got the chrome transmission pan, got our exhaust, scuffed it up a little bit so it doesn't look like it's a first owner. Did that nice wash on there. These tires never sand very well, so I didn't bother doing it. And then, as you can see, you can use the stock wheels with the fatter tires and the raised suspension for that little bit of a street machine look that the second owner of a car like that probably would want to do. We've got our black on black interior done. I wanted to do different tones with the car, but we're given a white stripe for the hood and a yellow stripe, so that was my options for the car. I went with a black interior. I wanted to do this in a green with the green, but I don't have a green stripe, of course, and then I would have done a nice white interior if I would have had the chance. But that is a build for another day. Got our wood trim. Not all of them had the wood trim, but I saw pictures of them with it, and I like doing that. It really brings out that black on black. Got our vinyl done, got our simple door handles and everything all done, and our carpets, center console, and that dashboard. There are, of course, nice dash decals for everything. I went ahead and just did it with my silver markers because they can barely be seen. It's faster, and sometimes I just like doing it that way because I've always done it that way. So I chose to do it that way. We're going to be putting the interior in, snapping our body on, getting our front and rear bumpers on, putting the decals on, giving it a brush of future floor polish, and I will be back for the final. Here you are. Revell USA's reissue of the 1970 Buick GSX in 1/24th scale, a 2-in-1 kit, is all done. Very easy kit to assemble. The parts count is just over 100. The decals go on super nice. There's only one tiny thing about the entire kit, and that is that I thought those decals were kind of open around the door handle. They are, but not open enough. They kind of shrinked up around that door handle. What I would recommend is you take an X-Acto knife or a hobby knife and cut that clear part out of the decal all the way so that it seats around the door handle better. By the time I had them off the backing sheet and with the decal solvent on, that's too late to start trying to cut away stuff. You'll ruin it. The car comes out looking exactly the part. I am really glad they include the center stripe decal. Great idea to paint that on there and then do the little red pinstripes would be mind-blowingly difficult for the average modeler. But here you can do it in white, you can do it in yellow, and you'll have the decals to do a proper GSX. Any other color of GSX, if they made them in any other color, you will need to do that center stripe on your own. They do include the decals to do it in another paint scheme as well, but I've had this kit in other issues and I had to build it up as a stock-ish GSX. I did build mine with the raised rear suspension and the fatter tires, but the stock wheels, I built it with the pretty much stock engine, but left the valve covers chrome, slotted valve covers, and I painted the intake as if it was an aftermarket intake on there. And that's how I wanted to do mine, was just a little like they had just done some things they wanted to do, like put bigger tires on the back end so they can go out and drag race their other big block buddies out on Grand Avenue and cruise around and have a great time. The hood mounted tachometer is awesome, and I did that in just a little bit of a different black, like I said, so it just, you can see it and it doesn't match the other flat black on the hood. I enjoyed the kit quite a bit. It goes together so nicely. You can see underneath, looks pretty awesome. We got the custom transmission pan and everything. The wheel and tire package snaps onto those axles nicely. The exhaust slides right in. I did have to cut it like I thought above the axle, but you can't tell by looking at it. You'll never tell. Got that GSX decal on the bottom of the spoiler in the back. It fits perfectly, so don't worry about that going on. And the side stripe decals and the stripe across the back of the spoiler all line up without even trying hard. Just line up that clear part of the decal with the door handles and you're done. The mirrors went on easier than I thought, since this little shelf here on the body is a little wider. So the mirrors did go on with some thick super glue and I didn't have any other issues than that. The interior paints up easily. We got our trim done. The hood fits right. The grill fits right. The rear bumper fits correctly. You're not going to have any problems building yours. I will put a link in the description where you can get this on pre-order from Model Roundup. I want to thank Revell USA for sending over this kit so you guys can see what's going to be in this issue. I want to thank all of you for watching, and I want to remind everyone to smile, have a good time, build your models for you and you alone, and we'll see all of you at the next review.